We are back and joined by broadcaster Bob Barker, who is the star of The Price is Right on CBS television. He's been there for 21 years. It is certainly the longest running daytime television program now in the history of the medium, and I think that Bob has been on television longer than any other single individual, with the possible exception of Ed Sullivan.
Sullivan, probably, yes.
23 years, he but you've been 37 years in the industry.
Well, I've been 37 with Truth or Consequence. Well, before I go on, may I tell you, I like your gray hair.
I like your gray hair, too.
I saw your opening, and I couldn't help but think, what beautiful hair you had.
Remember, by the way, when you allowed your hair to go au naturel, the hue
yes.
and cry in the press,
yes.
because Bob Barker's getting gray is news. Aren't you supposed to?
Well, I had tinted mine for years,
I know.
You know. And it began to get blue. And then they dyed it, and that made it red.
Yeah.
So I went on vacation, I let it go, and came back with white hair, and the people on the show liked it.
Yeah.
So I did the show with the gray hair, but we had taped ahead. So Tuesday, I had dark hair, and Wednesday, I came through the doors with white hair. And I got a letter from a man in the Midwest. He said, Bob, you must have had one hell of a night.
There's a fellow here in town, and I won't mention his name because I like him. He's a nice man, and he's a known personality, and he colors his hair. But he's now at an age where he must also color his eyebrows. And because, you know, you have to look in sync, and I want to say to him, hey, my friend, it's okay. You know, don't worry
sure.
about it. Let it go. Let me ask you here about your... I know that you prefer to be identified as an animal rights advocate rather than activist.
I was identified once in an interview as the oldest activist in the country. and I guess I'm that, an advocate. I work for animal protection, certainly.
Let me ask you here about extremes. Because I think there are extremes in all agenda.
Of course.
I've often wondered what it is about the dolphin. And I don't dislike dolphins. I don't want to see them killed. But if now and again one gets caught in a tuna net, I wonder if it's worth an international hue and cry. And I have to believe it's something to do with Flipper, the television program.
Well, as your guest, I hate to disagree with you, but I really
but
don't
you
think
may.
It goes back
I'm
to
I'm looking
that.
For education here. As I once said to
well,
you after
I
a program, I said, I think you're right, finally.
and for
a lot of years, I thought, you know, Bob has lost control, but I think you're right when it comes to animals and the need for their protection.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I think that more and more people across the country are beginning to agree that something must be done to protect animals. In the case of the dolphin, I really don't, I don't have the background to tell you a great deal about it, beyond the fact that I've read that they're highly intelligent and that they are friends of man.
Right.
You have heard of dolphins that have actually saved lives by pushing people toward shore
mm-hmm.
who were drowning and so on. And to think that these intelligent creatures are being uselessly destroyed is appalling.
I wouldn't want to see them uselessly destroyed, but you know, accidents do happen now and again.
Well, they happen in the case of the tuna nets far too often.
Mm-hmm.
But that is being corrected, fortunately, because
yeah.
people
okay.
are becoming more aware.
Okay. Let me ask you here about another one. And I know that this is going to sound really impertinent. Why isn't anybody protecting the cockroach? I mean, if we take it to its extreme...
That's interesting. I can see it now. Bob Barker, director of Americans for Cockroaches.
But
send me money,
but
please.
But we have huge industries that are set up to exterminate pests, whether
yes.
they be rats or... cockroaches or mosquitoes, ants, et cetera, et cetera. And by the way, I have nothing. But an extremist could really take it to the extreme and say we have no right to do that.
I know of no one who has.
No, but after tonight.
But you probably planted the thought.
So where what is advocacy and what is radical behavior?
Well, in my own case, it has been gradual. I had always loved animals. And as a kid in a little town in South Dakota, my mother and I lived in the only two-story building in town, a hotel. And when she wanted me, she would go up on the roof of this hotel and look for the dogs. And when she saw a pack of dogs, then she'd know that's where I was. And she'd fetch me. But as I grew older, I contributed to animal protection organizations, but I was not active in their work. And about 15 years ago, I was asked to be the chairman of Be Kind to Animals Week here in Los Angeles, and I accepted. And I did television interviews and radio interviews, newspaper interviews, and as a result, I was invited by organizations to participate in their work. And I accepted some of them. And as I began to do some of this work, and I began to do more reading and became aware of the terrible exploitation of animals in the United States, in the world, like thousands of other people, I just felt compelled to try to do something to rectify the situation. So I started out very gradually. I, as an example, had never even thought of being a vegetarian. I had read that it was very healthful.
Right.
But because of my concern for animals, I decided to become a vegetarian. Not totally. I first gave up red meat and fowl. And I felt better. And I went in for a physical, and my doctor said, whatever you're doing, keep it up. Man, he said, you are in great shape. And then I gave up fish and all meat. And I felt better. And so I can understand now why so many Americans are becoming vegetarians,
not because
of their interest in animals necessarily, but because of health.
Interest in their own good health. Let me ask you here, I've only got a minute left, so the answer will have to wait till the other side of the break, about the suit against you on behalf of the American Humane Association.
Certainly.
Involving a motion picture called Project X, and I believe another motion picture in which you have been quite vocal in saying that the American Humane Association was derelict in its responsibility to make certain that animals used in motion pictures and productions were being properly protected. I'm pretty well on track there as to what it is?
I have said that animals in the production of movies are not adequately protected.
Okay.
And the specific charges, I quoted investigative reports made by investigators for the Los Angeles Department of Animal Regulation.
Let me hold that thought through the break, and we'll start taking your calls here on the toll-free exchange at 800-745-CNBC. We'll be right back with Bob Barker from The Price is Right, animal rights advocate, after these messages. Thanks for watching, everybody.
Look closely. Can you...
We are back with Bob Barker talking about The Price is Right, which I want to get to in a second. But the lawsuit that they filed against you, what is their beef with you? I mean, it's not like you're against animals, for heaven's sake.
Oh, no, absolutely not. In 1987, Nancy Burnett of United Activists for Animal Rights and I, we had heard rumors about the chimps in this movie, Project X, being mistreated. And we accumulated enough evidence to get the city attorney interested, and he had the Los Angeles Department of Animal Regulation do an investigation.
Right.
Now, the first thing I did, I should say, is that I went to the then director of the Hollywood office of the American Humane Association and told her about what I had heard. And she denied that anything had happened and, as a matter of fact, tried to dissuade me from continuing. And in one of the conversations I had with her at this time, I said that I understood that animal trainers carried blackjacks when they worked with chimps. And she said, well, Bob, chimps are wild animals, and the animal trainers have to show them who's boss. Mm. And I decided that if this reflected the philosophy of the organization that had the obligation of protecting animals in movie production,
we've got a problem.
We have to pursue this. So we did, and we accumulated this evidence. They did this investigation, and the Department of Animal Regulation for the City of Los Angeles asked for charges to be filed against six animal trainers for 18 violations. But unfortunately, the statute of limitations had elapsed on the most appropriate charges, so they were not filed. But Nancy Burnett's organization went to the city and under the Freedom of Information Act secured the investigators' reports. And the reports were shocking. So we took those reports, and Nancy's organization ran ads in Variety quoting from these investigators' mm-hmm. reports in an effort to awaken the industry to what is really going on in the production of movies, so far as animals.
Suffice to say that they are now suing you for a combined total of $20 million.
That's right.
And that's still in the courts, and the decision is yet to come in.
We have been in the suit for about 3.5 years, and...
How much has this cost you?
Oh, it's cost me hundreds of thousands of dollars
really?
Out of my pocket. Of course. But I feel that it is money well spent in that... If we can ever get them into court and present the evidence that we have accumulated over the years, I think that it will awaken moviegoers to the fact that this whole system has to be changed. At one time, we thought that if the American Humane Association were replaced, everything might be all right.
Right.
But we no longer believe that. In fact, I think it would be difficult to find an organization that would accept the responsibility under the present terms. Mm-hmm. The whole system has to be changed.
Let me go to the phones. A lot of people on the line here for Bob Barker. Elliot in Rutland, Vermont, the birthplace of my dad. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir, Elliot, you're on.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
I'd like to say, first of all, Bob Barker, I'm a big fan of yours. And Tom, I'd just like to say to you real quick, that my sister, she works for Simon & Schuster in the publishing industry.
Right.
And I don't know if this is going to make you feel any better, but I think the reason that Mr. James Walcott is so concerned with men growing older is because his main hobby in life is very, very young boys. And so I hope that...
You didn't hear it here.
I hope that'll explain his obsession with men growing older a little bit to you. But anyway, Mr. Barker...
I hope that's not why you called, Elliot. Go ahead, please.
Jeez. Well, I happen to know it is true.
Oh.
But anyway, I'd like to say to Mr. Barker, I'd like to know how you feel about some of Tom was talking about this the other night. Someone called about the stars on the Oscars who were talking about political issues. And do you think that's a time and place? Because I actually think that is a time and place, because when you got so many people watching and they were talking about the Haitians... And I really sympathize with what was going on with the Haitians, and Tom Snyder doesn't seem to really care about them, and I'd like to know what you think about that.
Okay. Although you haven't got it quite right, Elliot, I think it'd be fine if Susan Sarandon and Tim Robbins would come on this program, or the Jay Leno Show, or David Letterman, and talk about that issue. I think that's fine.
How many people watch your program?
Very few compared to how many watch the Oscar Awards.
So don't you think it would make more sense that they should talk to lots of people, because nobody really seems to care about what's going on with the Haitians?
Well,
if they go on your show, they might as well be talking in a phone booth.
Okay, but thank you. But how about if they went on with Jay Leno or David Letterman, watched by millions and millions of people? But let me get Bob's thoughts on it.
When have Jay Leno and David Letterman ever spoke about something serious or important on their shows?
There's no way to win with you, is there, Elliot?
Well, why don't you just tell the truth?
I did tell the truth. What do you think about this man's question?
Well, first of all, I didn't see the Oscars.
Right.
So I'm not sure that I know what he's talking about,
well,
but
I would assume that some of the
presenters went into political...
Correct.
I think there's a time and a place for it, and I don't know what the situation was. Maybe it was appropriate. I don't know. I know in my own case... I've for many years closed my show with Help Control the Pet Population, Have Your Pets Spayed or Neutered.
Right.
And people have, it's reached a point I can walk into a bar.
Stayed and neutered.
Right. The bartender comes over and makes a remark about it. But I've worked that in to situations, and it was fun. It came off as fun. Now, I don't know how these things came off.
Well,
on
it's
the
almost
Academy
with Bob
Awards.
Barker, it's become a signature line.
It has.
That's fine, and it's one line, and it's not like you come out and make a 5-minute speech on every Price is Right. You wouldn't do that.
One time, I had the late Mark Goodson on Price is Right as a guest, and he said, "You know, Bob, if anything ever happens to me," he said, "I want to come back as one of your dogs." I said, "Mark, you got to remember, I have my dog spayed or neutered." He said, Forget that.
Back with more of your calls for Bob Barker of The Price is Right, and eventually on to the rest of our program. We will continue after these messages on the CNBC TV cable network. See you. underneath Akron, Ohio. Hello.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
Oh, hey, Bob, I love your show. I watch it all the time.
Good for you, John.
What's the craziest thing a contestant ever did on...
There are several.
Should we tell him?
Yeah, go ahead.
We were just talking about it, John. The most talked about single incident in Price is Right history was a young lady in a tube top who was seated in the audience, and her name was called to be a contestant, and she jumped to her feet and she began jumping up and down, and out they came over the tube top. She came on down and they came on out.
And I think that's probably one of the most watched blooper bits in the history of television is the day that happened.
It is indeed, and it is talked about wherever I go.
And wasn't there a time when the fair Janice, one of Barker's beauties, drove a car into a wall?
That's right. The lovely Janice was in this car off stage. We like to have these dramatic entrances sometimes, you know, to make the prize as exciting as possible. And the stagehands shoved this car on stage, and she was smiling at the camera, and she ran right into a wall. And I turned to the four people in contestants row, and I said, "What do you bid on that automobile with that damaged fender right over there?"
You know, one of the great lines when people are goofing about showbiz is... you'll look up at the scene and you'll say, "What does he win? Bob, it's a new car."
That's right.
By the way, the fellow that took the place of the late Johnny Olson, God rest his soul, Rod Roddy, is a tremendous asset to your program. He has really moved into that role very gracefully.
Johnny Olson was...
legendary.
Legendary. That word is overworked, but for Johnny it is fitting. Of radio as well as television. And when we lost Johnny, we were devastated. But we were so fortunate in finding Rod. Rod's in his eighth year on the show, mm-hmm. and I keep reminding him, I've made him a star.
You're right. Also, Rod has not missed a lot of meals. You know what I mean?
No, no.
We ought to get Rod on the vegetarian program.
Well, he wants to write a book. He wants to write a book called Come On Down, and the idea is to come on down and wait.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And I've convinced him it will never sell until he loses weight.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it won't.
You ain't going to buy a weight loss book from a fat man.
Right. And the reason we can talk like that is he's not here now.
That's right.
Here's Tammy in Wethersfield, Connecticut. Hello.
Good evening, Tom. I'm 22 years old, and I enjoy your show.
Thank you.
I find it very entertaining
and
informative. My question to Bob Barker.
Sure.
Mr. Bob Barker?
Yes.
Yes, I've been watching your show since I was 5 years old.
Well, that's wonderful. I'm so pleased. I'm flattered.
Well, thanks. And I give you both Nielsen ratings, and I enjoy the heck out of it beating those other shows.
Thank you.
Yep. Okay, my question is, have you ever considered politics?
Have I?
Yes.
Never. Okay. Never. I have absolutely no desire to go into politics, and... as I grow older and learn more about politics, I have less and less desire to be a part of it.
Well, as I say when asked that question, I couldn't stand the scrutiny, and I truly could not. You know,
you and I are the only two people I know who aren't running for mayor of Los Angeles right now.
Boy, there is a long...
Is it too late to file? I guess it is.
Yeah, it sure is. It is a long list, though. Tammy, thanks for your kind words. Here is Tom in Minneapolis. Hello.
Hi, Tom.
Hi.
I'd like to ask Bob Barker.
Go ahead.
What do you think of Howard Stern's...
Oh, let's take him off the air. Jeez. Oh, man. I want to tell you, folks, you really ought to pay more attention to the fact that they are censoring your buddy's radio show in Los Angeles, the Howard Stern Show, that they are editing the program on replay out here, and the possible First Amendment rights that are being infringed. If you'd pay more attention to that than all this goof stuff you do, you'd find your guys a lot better off. So 21 years. How many more years for Bob? You know, they ask Carson this all the time. And
well, my answer is that at my age, I don't think in terms of years. I'll be there next week.
It's always nice to see you, Mr. Barker.
Oh, thank you,
You're
Tom.
A great broadcaster. You've been a good friend to me over the years, and I appreciate your visiting us tonight.
I have enjoyed it, as I always do, and I hope you'll ask me back.
I will, and don't forget to have your pets spayed or neutered.
You said it.
All right.
You said it.
We'll be right back after these messages from our sponsors.